This is actually Wuji stance. The 2 feet are like this. The hands are this side. This is less. This will feel okay, but what you want to do is feel that you're centered right here. This is like 2 inches below your belly, but you can relax everything. Start relaxing. First your head, keep it straight. So your chin is slightly in. Your tongue, touch the top of your tip of your palate. Your shoulders are relaxed. There's no play, you're just there. You'll start feeling, okay, like my personal situation, since I have the stenosis of the back, I can feel it almost right away. And slowly, it dissipates. Just relax the whole body. And you'll feel some of your joints. Probably, you'll probably feel your ankle, unless you have something else done to you. You'll feel that more. Shoulders or tight hips, you'll start feeling like a tightness. Good. Walk around. And then we'll give the nasty one last. Okay, now these are all standing poses. These are exercises one actually does before you do Tai Chi and actually before you do eight pieces of brocade. Okay, and Tai Chi. Okay, we don't do that because it takes so long. Okay? Because you have to do it for a couple of minutes, and you know, later on, if we can have an hour and a half class or something, I would do it. You know, because I think it's very good. Okay, our last one, it is very simple. We actually extend out your feet. Okay, bend your knees. Now you have your elbows inward like this. Keep them straight. Sink. Elbows in. Yeah, those are out. Yeah. Relax your shoulders. Okay? Yeah, this is. Relax your shoulders. Yeah, there you go.
Relax your shoulders.
Okay, well, this is ongoing. This one you should feel warmth.
Feel it in my legs.
Yeah. Oh yeah, your ankle, yeah.
Lower your knee down.
Just come back up and relax. Okay? Now these, yeah, just relax.
Okay? Put your weight on the ball of your foot.
No, right in the center. Okay, that's a good thing. Okay, good question. Right now, all I want you to try to do is keep everything just firm. But later on, the thing is what you want to do is actually mentally that they're actually pigeon toed. But they're not. They're square, like this. But you feel that they're pigeon toed. Okay? I feel hot. When I do this, I feel very hot, warm. But I've been. So anyway, these are the three exercises that can really help your legs a lot. But you got to do them intelligently as you can. Relax all your joints. Your elbows sink. Your shoulders, well first of all, your shoulders sink. Your elbows sink. Your wrists are slightly down like this, so your hands are not facing up or anything. Your fingertips are facing slightly down. hurting, burning. This is a good thing. And you breathe deeply. And you'll see me, I'm rocking a little bit. This is natural. As long as you don't go like this way. But if you go forward and backward, all right, because you want to find that equilibrium spot in your feet. And relax your hips. Relax your knees. And now all you do is look. You feel, what do you feel?
She wants to sit down, right?
No, that's okay. That's okay. The second, okay, these are really good exercises to feel your balance and everything. But stay close to a bed, okay, when you're at home. If you do it at home, okay, stay close to a bed because a lot of times you're going to go back and forth. If you go side to side, then there's something else that's going on. But you're going to go back and forth, so like have the bed here or have the bed to your side that you just... You feel yourself losing balance, just go right into the bed. No, really, that's the way to do it, okay? The other way is this way.